Hi everyone, Grant for the Flame Learning channel. In the previous video, you were introduced to the storyboard within the effects environment. We looked at the standard workflow with the tracks mode, the primary track contextual view, and all the information that could be stored within the storyboard thumbnails. However, all that time, you were browsing on the range of a single clip when it was selected. In this video, you'll learn how to expand the frame range to the entire timeline, allowing you to navigate even faster as you make your way through the edit. This video is not footage specific, so you can use your own media to follow along. Continuing on from our previous timeline example, here we're in the effects environment, looking at the result view. With the shot currently selected, the time bar allows you to scrub to the first and last frame of the segment. This is known as the segment range. You cannot scroll beyond the frames in the selection. Now, if you want to see the source media plus any extra source media as handles, click the options pull-down menu and you can switch to the media range. The time bar updates and you can see the start and last frame of the media in the edit, as well as the extra hidden media on either side of the edited segment. So you're able to monitor all the source media without affecting the edit. Clicking these buttons will take you to the start and end frames of the media in the edit. You could also hold Control and press either square bracket. Clicking these buttons will take you to the beginning and end of the source media in the time bar. This is mapped to Control left arrow and Control right arrow. Now this is useful for focusing just on the source media. But if you are working across a sequence, you can switch the options pull-down menu to timeline range. This option displays the entire length of the timeline in the time bar. The different shades of gray indicate the different segments in the edit, and the blue marks show the currently selected segment. You can also hear the timeline audio during playback, as well as display a track waveform via the options pull-down menu. But if you scrub the time bar, you are still only viewing the media of the selected segment in the storyboard reel. This is because you are still looking at the result view for the selected segment. But if you switch to a contextual view, such as the primary track through the pull-down menu, or toggling the 4 keyboard shortcut, you are now able to see the combined result of all the video tracks and segments that make up the sequence. If you just want to see the context of the shots in the storyboard reel, you can switch the contextual view to Storyboard Context. You can also switch to this through the viewer pull-down menu, or toggle 4 to switch between primary track and storyboard context. So to reiterate, Storyboard Context currently focuses on the active video track, which is video track 1, and primary track contextual view combines all the video tracks together to give your final output from the sequence. So it's easy to switch between the different levels of the timeline. Please note that there is also a storyboard range in the options pull-down menu, but we'll come to that with the storyboard sorting and filtering in a later video. Now, since you can navigate the entire timeline in the time bar, you could hide the storyboard reel through the options pull-down menu or press Alt F1. The same shortcut will bring it back. Now you can scrub the time bar or press Play, and you should hear the timeline audio. In the player controls, you can navigate to the beginning and end of the time bar. These are mapped to Control left arrow and Control right arrow. And you can still go to the first and last frame of the selected segment, either with the buttons, or press Control followed by the left or right square brackets. To change the selected segment, you can click the previous or next transition buttons, or press the up and down arrow. Don't forget, you can also still click the thumbnail in the storyboard reel. What is interesting to know is if you play or scrub the time bar to a different segment, it won't change selection by default. The selection only changes if you use the previous and next transition functions or explicitly select a thumbnail. You can force the selection to update after scrubbing if you hold Shift and scrub the time bar. This also works holding the contextual button on the pen or mouse and scrubbing the time bar. If you want the selection behavior to be more permanent after scrubbing or playback, call up the main preferences menu. Go to the Timeline Effects Batch Effects menu. Here you can enable Auto Select on Scrub and Auto Select on Stop. Close the preferences menu. So when you scrub the time bar or stop playing the sequence, the selection will automatically shift to the segment under the positioner. It's a personal choice whether you want these options on or off. As a tip, if you were to now hold Shift and scrub the time bar, this will temporarily disable Auto Select on Scrub. So the function is inverted depending on the preferences. I'll turn mine off for now. So in this video, you've learned about the various frame ranges you can display and navigate in the time bar. You can focus on specific shots, or you can expand the time bar to work within the context of the sequence. Now all this time, the storyboard has been displayed in track mode. This means you see one video track at a time, and the thumbnails are in the order of the edit. However, sometimes, in the context of grading or VFX, you may want to temporarily reorder the shots for a more efficient workflow. For example, sort by the respective timecodes. So in the next video, we'll deep dive into the various storyboard sort modes for media sources, timeline tracks, and video versions. Don't forget to also check out the other features, workflows, and enhancements to Flame 2019. Comments, feedback, and suggestions are always welcome and appreciated. Please subscribe to the Flame Learning channel for future videos, and thanks for watching.